Bring, we have a special testimony of a financial blessing. Brother, you know, I'm sorry. We came this morning wanting to share this. I hope you all take it in and be blessed.
Hi, good morning, Northside Christian Center. It's good to be back with you guys again, just worshiping the Lord. Wherever worship is, you know, that's just where I'm at. But I just want to share a really quick testimony with you guys. I attend Oral Roberts University, and so last semester was a great year, a great semester and all. However, coming back for this semester, I had a balance outstanding from last semester, like $8,000. And then also for this semester as well, there's another balance for like $16,000 or something like that. So I came back to school on the 4th or 5th, somewhere there of January, and we're supposed to be registering and getting your classes put together and everything. But I was not able to do that because I didn't have the money to pay for last year's balance and this semester's balance as well. So I have until the 19th of January to complete everything and to make my payments so that I could register for classes. So just to make it short, the 19th came around and I didn't have the money. So I was like, okay, God, I know you called me here, and you know, wherever you lead us, you will provide the resources for us to continue once we continue to, you know, walk in your purpose. And so the 19th came around. And it's like, you know, there's nothing, there's no money, there's like no money at all. My church back home in Jamaica, they tried to raise some funds. It was like $1,500, which still wasn't enough to pay at least last semester's balance. Before that, actually, I was still going to classes because they said you should still go to classes until you're able to pay until the 19th. There was one day, the 15th of January, I think it was, my teacher, she had a scripture that says, cast your cares on him for he cares for you. And then later that day, my mom, she sent me that same scripture. And then the same day in chapel, the president spoke about, you know, not worrying or anything about that. So, like, I was at peace the whole time. But at the same time, the human flesh wants to come in like, okay, God, you know, the 19th is like tomorrow, what is happening, you know. But I was at peace about it, and even if I did go back home, I was still at peace, like, God, you know, if you only wanted me here for one semester, that's fine, you know. But, so the 19th came around, no money, and so I went to the International Admissions Counselor, and she was like, well, if you don't have the money, you pretty much have to leave, or transfer to another school that you could probably afford. And, I mean, the school had helped earlier because they gave me some other scholarships and stuff. So it's not like, you know, they're kicking me out and say, hey, we can't do anything about it. But they did give me some scholarships before, and so I was grateful for that. So the 19th was a Wednesday, which is the last day to register. And then, so I have to withdraw from the school the following day and also cancel my dorm housing. So the 20th, which is a Thursday, came, and I went and did all that, put all the paperwork and everything. And so the Friday, we had chapel, and you know, I was just at peace about it. My God, okay, you know, you're in control of the situation. The 19th has passed. You know, pretty much I have to leave, and so I'm like, okay, I'll stay until Monday, just to get my ticket and everything information so I can fly back home. So the Friday later on in the evening, I got an email about a scholarship, but it was like, I thought it was just one of those regular emails that I normally get. So I just like, okay, God, fine, whatever. And so I filled out the paperwork for that scholarship and sent it in, not really expecting anything in return or anything of a great value. And so Monday came, I was like, okay, I need to start packing my stuff and prepare to go back home. But I didn't buy my ticket as yet. And so I got up about 10 o'clock and got a call at 11 from ORU, and they're saying that they have a scholarship for me. I'm like, okay, fine. It's probably like $3,000, like, really can't really do anything. And she was, so she said that, you know, today is my best day. I'm like, okay, cool. And yeah, because I'm like, okay, you know, it's a scholarship, it's probably like $2,000. So then she said to me, yeah, you got the scholarship, and you can now, you should go and complete registration. So I logged on to my system, and when I checked, the scholarship was for $10,000. I was able to clear my balance from last semester. I'm putting a portion of that towards this semester, and I'm still at ORU right now, and I'm really expecting God to complete the rest of it, because if He's brought me this far, He will complete it. So just to encourage you guys, be faithful, continue to trust in Him, even when it doesn't seem like it's going to work out. Be that crazy Christian for God that speaks things into being as though they weren't. Amen. So just to encourage you guys, and thank you.
No. You need to bless us today. We all need some encouragement. Yes, and we just need to go blindly sometimes into the Lord, following the Lord, because He just has things for us because we are His children, just like we would do for our own children. If they needed something, we start scraping and digging and figuring out how we can do. We shift this over here, and I pay that a little later. I just pay some here and make that work over here. God is just so awesome. And we appreciate you for your testimony. Oh my God, just faith. Young people, poor senior people. This is young people. And I thank God for that testimony.